Yo guys, Jonathan here from youtube.com/TLD here with the Superfly Talk. Got some very special guest, the one and only Sara Dietschy.
No, you can't do that. I was ready to do the hey guys, this is Austin.
He mixed it up.
Wait your turn.
Hey guys.
It's okay, you can do it.
And the always lovely Austin Evans. Today we are talking AI, where it's at with smartphones, where it's headed in the future, and potentially how it could affect love and relationships.
So as a from your perspective, what would be one thing you would want like that would be helpful on a relationship level?
A relationship level. Probably, you know, I think it could offer insights in terms of the other human, you know, so say you're in a relationship and maybe they had some bad emails come through, some bad text messages, maybe the phone's kind of gauging their emotional state, and then the significant other gets a notification, hey, you gotta kind of like tiptoe around your other person's feelings today because they had a rough one.
Okay, I take back everything I said before. This is amazing.
That's
I need
right,
this in my life.
Right? I feel like it would save relationships.
It's like having like a real assistant, right? Like not just right. like something like super basic, but like imagine having an actual friend to kind of be over your shoulder like, right. hey, you don't see this, but you're messing up in a big way.
Right.
You know, pay attention. And obviously that's a little bit sort of over the top. And obviously your phone is not going to be like that person yet.
Yes.
But you can kind of see like as things sort of start developing that there's that sort of potential mm-hmm. that it could actually be something that's super useful in life.
Yeah. So in a nutshell, hopefully it's going to save
relationships everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yes.
Everywhere.
I'm just going to rely on the phone to be thoughtful for me.
You might fall in love with the phone. There might not have to be another significant other.
Yeah, that kind of got me thinking right there when you talked about how it's reading your messages and emails. Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah.
In a weird way, like it's going to know you had a bad day, right?
Yeah. it's the best personal assistant.
Or, hey, maybe you're texting this person.
Yeah.
Calm down. Maybe. Yeah.
Well, like,
well, I mean, I never thought about that, but talking in terms of relationships and love life and stuff, you know, maybe your phone can give you red flags or something. Or
it's like, no, are you sure you want to say that? No, that's a bad idea.
Yeah, it can give you some advice, dating.
It kind of works like that to agree right now, because I mean, you know, when you go to open up like a text or something, like it'll start to sort of autofill what you're going to say. And it's just like, oh, right, don't say that, you're an idiot. You know, like there's like some things that like you could sort of start with. But then you imagine as it gets smarter and smarter and really knows like, oh, this is the relationship with this person. This is kind of. Yeah, exactly. It's just like, hey, remind that this is your birthday or this is an anniversary or something. Like, you can kind of actually be proactive and be thoughtful when you aren't. Although I'm always thoughtful. Don't worry about that part. Not for me. It's for other people
right,
who aren't
right.
thoughtful.
I'm going to bet that you're going to get the notification that says, hey, bring flowers home.
No, never. I don't know what you're talking about.
But it's cool to think that as technology gets better and better, that there's all these possibilities that open up just as the tech that we use every day gets smarter and smarter.
And I think it's about enhancing real life. To
yes.
where it's not all about phone, but it's how can we take this technology, bring it to the real world, how can it enhance your love life?
Knows you're on a date, and it's like, hey, get off your phone.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's like, don't look at me anymore.
Exactly.
that would be a great idea.
Yeah.
That's going to be the saver right there. Yeah, so I'm excited to see where it heads in the future with that.
Yeah.
We just talked about AI, and I got a surprise.
A surprise? Oh boy, tell me more.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Don't close your eyes.
Okay.
Oh, I think I know what this is.
What is it?
It is the Honor of View10.
Now, word on the street is it's packing some power inside.
Yeah, well, it's got the Kirin 970 processor, which I'm about to go totally into nerd town, but it's really cool. So not only is it a powerful processor in like the sort of traditional sense, but it also has a dedicated neural processing unit, which essentially means that there's machine learning built in. Stop looking at me like that. You know this gets me excited. This is cool stuff, okay? So what it's doing is it's actually not only it gives you some cool features, which we'll probably talk about in a minute, but it also is learning, right? So the idea is that not only is it powerful and doing a lot today, but it's only going to get better as time goes on, as it just learns more and more about what you do, is more app supported. Like, there's just a lot of interesting stuff that it's going to be able to do.
Now, what I think is cool is if you imagine it in the work environment, so say your team all had these in their pocket.
So the idea that everyone has like an actually smart assistant to help them kind of not be late to work or remember to text you when you're coming in late to work.
Yeah, or
not like anything
or maybe in a situation where you're out on production in a different country maybe.
And you have like the actual translation?
Yeah, so I've been in situations where you have to do interviews or meetings and it's sometimes a little hard to communicate when you don't know that language. So, and I know you you're always all over the place.
You know, all of us make videos, and we make videos across the world. And so it's super exciting to take that power of the processor and really have it come in ways that's super practical.
Yeah.
I mean, Austin, let's say that you are a Spanish YouTuber that I'm about to interview. But I don't speak Spanish, so how am I going to ask
either.
You that question?
We'll have to be the Spanish YouTuber. We'll see.
So I'm going to say in English the question, and then hopefully it'll translate to Spanish. And then we'll test out your Spanish, Austin. Hey, Austin, when did you start making videos?
Hey, Austin, cuando empezaste a hacer videos?
Oh, no.
No,
that's cheating, though. You gotta
do it without cheating.
Yes, yes. Okay.
Wait, okay.
So the Spanish words are now on the screen. Austin, you are the Spanish YouTuber.
Okay.
Read that out to us.
Hey, Austin. ¿Cuándo empezaste a hacer videos?
You know what? Because I don't know Spanish, I'm gonna say great job. And it's taking. I think AI has a lot to do with taking data and taking so much information and really packing it into something that people can understand. And so especially, you know, we make videos, we collaborate with people. I think bringing that into like the workplace with collaboration, saying, oh, this person can't make it, maybe your calendar updates, and depending on other information, you know, it makes new plans.
And the idea that having something smart, that opens up so many possibilities, mm-hmm. right? Where it's like, you might not necessarily think like, oh, let me connect this dot with that dot. But the phone's like, oh, I know that this is what you're doing. Mm-hmm. This is, you know, who you're talking to. Like, the more information it knows, and when it actually has some intelligence behind it, it can sort of connect a lot of dots and make your life easier in a lot of ways that you might not necessarily think of.
Yeah, exactly.
It's going to say, you haven't collabed with Austin Evans in 2 years. Or in my case, it's going to say, you collab with Austin like 7 times.
Just stop. Like, every time you collab, I see your subscriber numbers drop. This is a terrible idea. It's like every time, like, when the Austin mode on the camera shows up, it's like, eh, it's like there's a giant X on my face.
Yeah.
See? AI, man, it's smart.
Now we're talking AI, entertainment, gaming, traveling, maybe even some selfies.
I do a few of those. Mm-hmm. Maybe not selfies, but I do all the other things all the time. We actually have AI on board with gaming, right? So, of course, you need a powerful processor to be able to game properly. But there's also some other cool stuff that you can actually take advantage of. So if I actually pull up a game here, one of the cool things here is that if I jump into it, you'll see that not only does it take up the full screen, but say I get like a notification or something right now. Well, I'm in the middle of my game. I don't want to, you know, die because mom texted me asking for milk or something. So what you can do, hey, it happens, okay?
Okay, hey, 2% or whole?
Whole. 2%.
I don't know what your mom likes.
Well, you know, I mean, it's like, there's only so health, like, you don't need to be that healthy in life. That's all I'm trying to say. But yeah, so you can actually game and not have to deal with, like, notifications or whatever. The phone is smart enough to know, oh, look, this is what I'm doing. I'm gaming. I don't want to be interrupted. Mom, just give me, like, 5 more minutes. It's fine. And what's also cool is that because this has such a large battery, we're getting not only, like, about a day and a half of usage, but almost more importantly than that, say you're gaming all day, got to hit that charger, for like 20 minutes, you can supercharge the battery up to like a full day of usage. So, pretty much not, you're unstoppable. So.
Quick gaming, man. We're not gonna get anything done. We gotta go to selfies.
No. It's work, okay?
Sara, take it away.
Okay, well, the thing that makes a good picture, I think, is something that resembles some maybe more expensive cameras. You have DSLRs, you know, they're really good about blurring the background, which is called bokeh. And so with this, it uses AI to really detect where are the edges with the face. It separates the person and the background. And I would like to demonstrate that with a selfie. Okay. All right, so we're gonna take a selfie here. See, the background is already pretty blurred. Okay, smile, Austin.
You got me, didn't you?
Perfect. And see, it even got the blur around John's fingers.
Yeah, the way it should be.
Yes, yes. And
it
see,
nice,
yeah, it separates us from the background. Yeah, it's a pretty darn good picture. And so not only do you have that, you know, in this camera, but you can take your selfies, superfy them, make them look beautiful.
So clearly, beautiful selfies not a problem, but also there's some love on the rear cameras too. We got two of them here, 16 to 20 megapixels. And what's cool is we got a beautiful f1.8 aperture.
Which makes not only better photos, but especially when it comes to low light, it allows you to gather a lot more light in. Because I feel like with a lot of smartphones, you know, you're in like a restaurant or some sort of like dim area, and you're like, hey, let's take a picture. Oh, ooh. But actually having that aperture makes a big difference. Plus having the secondary camera means that you actually have more to pull from.
There you go. So whether it's selfies, rear-facing cameras, low light, gaming, love
life.
Yep.
Becoming a creator of the next Austin Evans. This is where it's taking you. Thank you, Austin Evans.
Of course.
Thank you, Sara. And we'll catch you guys later after we
fight to the death.
You're dead.
It's like straight for the neck, man.
Right in the jugular. You're dead. Later. You're dead.